CIS Azure Benchmark Section 2.1.5 covers enabling Microsoft Defender for SQL Server on machines. Keep in mind this is a Level 2 recommendation, so added cost and complexity should be expected. Some of the protections offered by Microsoft Defender for SQL Servers on machines includes password attack detection, so looking for things like password brute forcing, credential stuffing, or password spraying. Exploit detection, so looking for SQL injection attempts or other malformed queries or statements that are hitting the database, and any other traffic that might be anomalous in that vein. This also includes data exfiltration, so looking for any data flows out of or into the database that might indicate that some sort of unexpected activity is occurring. So this could be small amounts of data being transferred to an unknown location, or a larger amount of data that's being transferred. Lastly, it includes unauthorized access detection. So looking for things like access from unknown IP addresses, whether that's within the Azure environment or elsewhere. Looking for connections from unknown locations, so areas in a different region than expected, or maybe in from a different country. This also includes looking for access from within the Azure environment, whether that's inside of your own subscription or outside of your subscription within the larger Azure environment. This also includes a vulnerability scanning component that can allow you to identify and get alerts on vulnerabilities that are identified with the SQL instance. Keep in mind this plan supports hybrid and multi-cloud environments. So this could include your private cloud on-prem, or it could include instances in AWS and GCP. And remember, for more cloud security guidance, connect with us.